if they're okay with it, then only we're doing it. But I forgot to ask Chaitanya because of all the chaos outside. So really sorry about it.
We still can't hear you.
Can you hear me now? Okay. So now that's what you call a fearless, completely assured debut, and that's the thing. Okay, Chaitanya. Those are the And if I'm not wrong, Chaitanya is still under 25 or have you crossed
it? No, man.
Okay. He's under 30 maybe.
Under 30,
and must be one of the most, one of the youngest filmmaker in this film festival. Also, this is the only Indian film in international competition at this Mumbai Film Festival. I'll start with one or two questions and then we'll open the house. So, Chaitanya, what is the trigger point for this?
Well, hold up the mic to your...
My yes. voice is way loud. Still, okay. So, what was the trigger point for this? The story, were you part of this, their cultural activities? That's how it started? Or you were writing and then you become that Kalamanch activities? How it started, the whole...
No, actually, what happened was it was a two-fold process. One was, of course, the setting of the judiciary excited me because generally we see like Jat Saab and Milord and, you know, very dramatic kind of a courtroom setting. So, a lower court... And to explore a trial in that was one of the things that really excited me because I thought it would be, you know, funny in a way or absurd maybe even. And then what I discovered was this world of cultural activists and protest singers. You know, it was inspired by Kabir Kalamanch, Sambhaji Bhagat. Then that opened up a completely different world for me. And I like doing research. So both these areas allowed a lot of research. So that's how it actually happened.
Also, if you can talk about the tone and the treatment of the film, you are in no hurry to rush any of the scenes. They are almost static, your camera is, they don't want to show us great cinematography. The conventional language of cinema, your camera remains at the frame, the activities move on. So if you can talk about the tone and treatment, the content dictated it or why you decided to go about it?
Again, I think the answer is a little more complex. I mean, I would like to believe that this form is assisting the content. But apart from that, I think it's also an influence of the kind of films that I personally like watching and the kind of filmmakers that I like watching who have influenced my philosophy of filmmaking. It's, you know, it's got to do with my own relationship with time and space and things like that. The arty-farty stuff that nobody wants to know.
Also, for those who don't know, Chaitanya hasn't gone to any film school. Chaitanya hasn't assisted anyone. So he directed one documentary. He made one short film, which went to film festivals. And this is the debut feature. So no film school, no film school. Now the house is open. Please raise your hand. I'll try to pass the mic. Or if your voice is loud,
there are any questions for other members of the crew? They're all here. Yes.
Where's the producer? Where's the man who made it
happen? Yes, Vivek.
Please come
in front. Yeah. It's 20 minutes lighter, and without the glass, he's the lawyer. Hard to recognize.
Please raise your hand. I'll try
this one.
Yeah, hi. You're the whole...
okay, one thing is the house lights are really dim right now, so we can't see most of you. So please excuse us if you're... Yeah, but...
Now can you see me?
No.
Question is more important.
Yeah, hi.
Go on. So yeah, your last episode of the judge and his trip, like, did you just write the entire episode just for that one shot, the last shot? Because it's a very resonating shot.
No.
So you have had that in mind that you had to show the like his
yes.
personal space also
yes.
by the end of
it. Yes.
Thank you.
How long in the making?
I was just discussing this with Vivek on the flight yesterday that I've personally been working on this for 3 years now. I mean 3 years of active work, and I was complaining that I've only taken a break for a month. Anyway, so but yeah, 3 years, and I mean, which includes 1 year of script writing, 1 year of pre-production and going to markets and trying to raise funds, and then post-production also took us quite a while, basically. So yeah, 3 years total.
You reference a lot of things.
Hello. Yeah, I can't see. We can hear you.
You reference a lot of things, including the Kabir Kalamanch, as you mentioned. You also referenced the Vilas Ghobre suicide.
Then there's the Ramabai Colony shootings, also somewhat referenced in the setting of the first protest scene. Was there any specific reference for the advocate's role, or was it an entirely fictional role?
There are references for all the characters, but there's no one specific reference. It's an amalgamation of many different references. But yeah, there are references for the advocate's character and who he was studying and he was. But I can't like give you one name.
For him, the producer's role came in first. The actor's,
how did
that happen?
I had worked with Chaitanya in a play before. That's how we met. This was about 6-7 years ago. And then we met again in 2011. I'd left the country and I'd come back. And it was quite organic, actually. I felt that there was a need to for his voice to be heard. I think he's a very special director and a very, very young, talented writer as well. So, yeah, it was just very organic and nobody else was stepping up. I mean, we tried going around to many different markets. We tried to look for funding. Went to national. Nobody else was doing it, to be honest. Yeah. Thank you.
Hello. मेरा आपसे मैं आत्महत्या की जो सेक्शन है आईपीसी में 309 आत्महत्या की कोशिश करना. मैं इसमें विरोधाभास है क्योंकि कोर्ट ने कभी भी क्लियर नहीं किया है ये कोर्ट ने इसे अपराध कहा है क्योंकि और ये अपराध नहीं है. ये एक ऐसा अपराध है अगर जिसमें आप नाकाम रहे करने में तो आपको कोर्ट सजा दे पाएगा. अगर आप उसे करने में कामयाब हो गए तो आपका कोई कुछ नहीं बिगाड़ सकता. तो इसमें विरोधाभास है 309 में. और मैं 306 की बात करना चाहूँगा कि एबटमेंट ऑफ सोसाइटी उकसाना, मतलब उकसाना किसी भी चीज में हो सकता है. फिर इसने मुझे चोरी करने के लिए उकसा दिया, आत्महत्या के लिए उकसा दिया. तो ये इट्स नॉट क्लियर इन आवर जुडिशरी. और इसके बारे में दिल्ली में भी लोगों ने काफी पेटिशंस वगैरह किए हैं. आप इस पर क्या कहना चाहेंगे और आपकी क्या रिसर्च थी इस पर 309 सेक्शन पर और 306 सेक्शन पर?
हाँ जी, एक्चुअली हमने बहुत सारे लॉयर्स को इसके बारे में कंसल्ट किया था और रिसर्च किया था. मगर मेरे लिए ये जो केस है अबेटमेंट ऑफ सुसाइड वो मतलब एक इट वाज लाइक अ स्प्रिंग बोर्ड. इट वाज अ कैटलिस्ट फॉर मी टू एक्सप्लोर अदर थिंग्स. मुझे कुछ और चीजों में इंटरेस्ट था. सो फॉर मी दिस वाज अ स्प्रिंग बोर्ड. ऐसा नहीं था कि मुझे इस जो मुद्दा आप उठा रहे उसे एक्सप्लोर करने के लिए मैंने ये स्क्रिप्ट लिखी या बट आई गेट व्हाट यू आर सेइंग. आई सी योर पॉइंट. या
यस सर.
हाय. I just wanted to say congratulations to your cast. It was wonderful, subtle work. I really enjoyed watching all three deeds. How did you find it?
Shirish Pawar is here. Shirish, please.
Can I have you?
Shirish, please come. The casting director is not here. He is working on another film right now, Sachit Purane. And Vishwam Paralkar, the associate casting director, is here as well. Where is Vishwam? Vishwam? Vishwam, stand up. So it was about 8 months of auditions where we didn't want typical actors, not for the most part. So we approached the bank employees, railway employees, and all kinds of people, marriage bureaus, general societies, our relatives, so senior citizen clubs. So it was a long process, and that, in that we found Shirish or Veera Sathidhar, who plays the main singer. Or who play Sharmila, which is played by Usha Bane, who plays the manual worker's wife. So that was the process. And for the lead characters, I thought it was too much of a risk, or I don't know, if too much of a challenge, because there were so many different scenes with so many different moods. So I wanted actors who have not been seen on too many films or done too much of television, and that's how we decided to work with Anjali, who's a fantastic actress, of course, and Vivek. Yeah.
Someone there wanted the mic.
Hi.
Hi.
I think it felt as if the whole film was a criticism of middle class India, like people like us. Would you care to comment on that?
No. Fond of queuing up watching the film, you know what I mean? It's interesting, these theories. Yeah.
Yes,
I agree with all and I disagree with all. So the movie strings along a lot of random events, such as the lower judiciary system, gutter worker, someone who works in the gutters, and Marathi housewife. So, did you come up with the story first and then did the research, or was it as you did the research that you came up with the story? It all happened together, but I must tell you that all the scenes of the personal lives of the lawyers and the judge, I had those first in my head, and I was looking for the case. I mean, for the longest time, I didn't have the case, like what exactly the case would be. So that actually came in quite late into my scripting process, but of course, I don't start writing the script before I have everything in place. But that was like the last thing that came to me was the idea of the abetment of suicide, and after that, the script kind of fell in place in a few months' time. But yeah, you're right. The cultural nuances and the scenes of the characters outside of the courtroom came first. Yeah.
Okay, another question. You mentioned that you had some influences that influenced you to put in the still frames, right?
So I put in the?
Still frames in the movies.
Still frames?
As in
the shooting style. Yeah, yeah, yeah. So?
Could you name some of the influences?
No, I don't like name throwing and name dropping. I'm sorry. I mean, maybe personally I can tell. I'm sorry.
Hey, tell you the ones he is dismissive about.
No. See, man, that's another corner.
Okay, anyone else?
Yeah.
Hi. This is with reference to the that one shot, which was like after the court has closed, like it was a never ending kind of thing. Because the lights went out at the end. Like, just some things like to relate to that court cases never end. Like, they keep on going. Like, was it something parallel? Like, was it not that?
I'm sorry, I guess I'm really bad at Q&As in some ways, but I wouldn't. I think it's open to interpretation and everyone can kind of find their own meaning to the scenes. Sorry. I don't want to be pretentious, I'm sorry, but yeah.
It's my interpretation of that scene.
It's a really nice interpretation.
Do I see a hand there? Hi, I'm Ashish. I'm from Mumbai.
Hi, I have two
questions. My first one is, you come from a background of theatre, and your theatre influence is slightly visible to some of us who are a little more familiar with your work.
Do you consider returning to theatre or taking part in theatre once again? I can see the Gujarati theatre influence and your college theatre.
It was because I've done so much of bad theatre when I was growing up. It definitely helped in blocking the scene of the... It was a Marathi play, actually. But yeah, it really helped in blocking that scene, for sure. And I don't know about theatre. Right now, it's not in my mind, but sure, why not?
Also, one small question. The court closing scene and the slow fade out to black.
Yeah.
Did you ever consider that as the ending of the film? By
no.
In any
no.
Edit case?
No.
Okay.
Thank
no.
you. Thanks. So, obviously, one of the things that do stand out in the film are the performances along with everything else. So, you mentioned that you went with a lot of non-actors in the film, right? So, it will be nice to understand your process after you cast them.
Right.
About how did you work with them, especially for me, the scene that stands out is the wife of the gutter worker, especially in the court. So, to bring her to that level, and did you actually make her nervous, didn't tell her what it is about, did you hide some things from her? Sorry? Sure. Anybody wants to talk about it?
Okay. See, good actors. the thing is, it's very in her. She's an exceptional case because she is actually the wife of a manhole worker who actually died, and she actually had to do a lot of court rounds. And on an average, we've done about 30 to 40 takes for most of the scenes. For example, the Gujarati parents, we've done 63 takes or something, 67 or something. But with her, it's really like we've done probably the shortest amount of takes, like 5 takes or something. And all of them were perfect. So she's an exceptional case. But apart from that, casting was like, it was not one round or two rounds. It was an extensive process where it's a long story, but the first time we wouldn't make them aware of the camera at all. We would do it in Vishwam's house in a very friendly environment. Each audition would last about half an hour. They would just talk about themselves. In the second round, we would make them aware of the camera, and we would make them aware that we would get a proxy boom man, and just to see how they reacted to pressure. So we auditioned a lot of people. We created a database of about 1,800 or 2,000 people of non-professional actors. And then the third round was, of course, doing it with scripted lines, because everything is scripted. There are no improvisations in the film, except maybe certain bits in the picnic sequence at the end. And then they had to work with the other shortlisted candidates to see how the equation was. So maybe somebody else wants to add half, because these are two theatre actors who have done a lot of theatre, and they had to work with non-professional actors, and it had to all seem consistent. So maybe they want to add something.
The overall process was very challenging, because I mostly do theatre, so working with Chaitanya was very challenging, because he always used to say no expressions, you have to be very normal. So it was very difficult for me, because right now I'm doing a comedy play, I'm always giving a lot of expressions. So it was really a challenge to control yourself and not to do anything extra, and of course the takes and the... We had full faith in the script and the way the workshops were conducted with the non-actors. Mm-hmm. Like for example, my son, we did a lot of scenes together, even with Usha Bane, the wife of the Safai Kamgar. Mm-hmm. We did a lot of cross questioning with Veera, the Shahir. So we did a lot of exercises, especially rehearsing the scenes. So we were very well equipped when we were on the floor.
It's the same, it's just you have to work with them quite a bit. In fact, I learned a lot working with them, also to forget my own craft. That was a lot of fun. And also I really liked his process of getting 30, 40 takes, because you get to, first there was a lot of prep, so you had to do a lot of homework. And so by the time you get up on set, and then if he gives you the whole day to do a scene and you've got 30 takes, you just settled in, you know, you just keep settling in. And that was great. And anytime I felt like I was acting, I'd look across, and you know, those guys were so good. And Usha especially, I think she's exceptional. But yeah.
And that required setting up the whole shoot in a particular way that had an impact on the production and the budget. But we had a good producer, so...
Did you think of any alternative endings?
No.
How did you go about researching?
Lots of books, meeting a lot of lawyers, interviewing academics, meeting protest singers, meeting people who've been arrested and re-arrested. And the script consultant on the film is Ramu Ramanathan, who's like somebody who I admire a lot and I consider him my mentor. He helped me a lot. And of course, people like Sambhaji Bhagat and lawyers like Susan Abraham helped us a lot. So that was the whole process of research, basically.
And going to court a lot,
including for the production designers who had to recreate the courts, you know, on a studio floor. So yeah.
Chaitanya, the folk singer, the person who played the folk singer's character. Mm-hmm. Is he the regular folk singer or?
He's never faced the camera. Yeah. He's not a singer. He's not an actor. He's actually a publisher of a magazine called Vidrohi.
and he works out of Delhi. He's from Nagpur, and no, he's a, actually a very simple person who has got nothing to do with film. He's aware of the situation of these folk singers because he's friends with many of them. I mean, he's a human rights worker, basically. He's a human rights activist, but yeah, he's not a singer. He's not even sung the songs, actually. The songs are sung by Sambhaji Bhagat.
So, you know, you said 30, 40, maybe sometimes even 60 days. So, during, what? How many days did you shoot this? 45 days. 45. So, with time, and this is your first feature, I want to understand that what did you feel helps if you go, say, over 15 days, 20 days? I mean, what did you realize or understand?
Right. It's not like we would get it on the first day and then you do 30 takes. I mean, we would get it only around the 20th or the 22nd take, and then we would do about another 7 takes just to try our luck if we're getting something better. Because what's happening is the actors are getting it out of their system, all the acting, and they're getting comfortable with each other and the ambience and the lines. And also, I am shaping the scene continuously as I am doing the retakes. And the problem is that there are only about 105 or 110 cuts in the film. So they're all like basically very, very long scenes. Even the courtroom scenes that we have edited, they were all like done in real time, you know, in one go. So the problem is if anybody commits a mistake, at any point you have to start all over again. So that is why,
Chaitanya, sorry, this is only to get a yes from you.
This is only to get a yes from you
because you've been saying far too many no's.
Yes.
Would you love Michael Haneke to watch Code?
Yes.
Okay.
In fact, we're trying to get him to watch it.
There is a, you know, what might happen is that you're also showing the lives of these lawyers. So what might happen is that your script might meander with them too much. So how did you kind of avoid that? Or what did you do to so that nothing happens?
Well, I hope it does not meander. I mean, I don't think anybody sets to, you know, write a meandering script. But yeah, I hope it's not meandering. Yeah, I didn't do anything special to avoid. I just wrote what I thought of.
Yeah. Where is the guy who played the character of Judge?
Yeah, Pradeep Joshi. Actually, the thing is that Vivek and me have been traveling quite a bit. We've been attending festivals. We just landed in Mumbai today, so we didn't get the time to coordinate with all the actors. That's the real problem, and which is why the film was scheduled so late in the Mami schedule as well. But he's around, and we'll try to invite him tomorrow. He's actually a music teacher who works with differently abled students. And he's a music composer.
He's not a theater artist.
He is a theatre artist also. He's done some theatre as well. And he's composed a lot of music for theatre and he works full time in the school as a music teacher.
We did a lot of improvisation over there, I think.
No, there are no improvisations. Sorry, except for the picnic scene.
Okay, yeah.
Okay, guys, congratulations. Wonderful film over here.
Thank you.
What was the production budget of the film? Production cost?
No!
Please. I mean, just give me a general idea of like the money part.
It's under $10 million.
Nice.
Anyone else, or we'll wrap it up. Thank you, guys. Thanks for coming.